Hello and welcome to Bangkok. Today I'll be flying in Emirates A380 First Class to Hong Kong. That's right, you didn't hear me wrong. Emirates does have fifth freedom rides between these two cities, and this is one of the most affordable ways to experience one of the world's best first class products.
Bangkok, the capital of Thailand, is a city that blends ancient traditions with modern wonders. Nestled along the Chao Phraya River, it entices visitors with its bustling markets, ornate temples, and dynamic cityscape. Emirates provides a complimentary chauffeur service to eligible business and first-class passengers. Sadly, my ticket was not qualified. The most convenient public transport option to reach Bangkok Suvarnabhumi Airport is the airport rail link. Starting from Phraya Thai Station, the fare is 45 baht for an 8-stop journey and takes just 30 minutes to reach the airport. The train operates from approximately 6 a.m. to midnight daily. Emirates uses check-in bay U at Suvarnabhumi. As of August 2023, the airline operates 5 daily flights to and from Dubai, one of which continues to Hong Kong. There are 4 separate check-in lanes, and the signs are fairly self-explanatory. Check-in for my Emirates flight opened precisely 3.5 hours before departure, not a minute early. First-class passengers receive absolute priority. Despite the long line in other queues, I was the first to be checked in. After getting your boarding pass, eligible passengers can use the express pass for immigration and security. I got through in no time. Upon clearing security, you'll be welcomed by various duty-free shops. And there are many signs to help you find the boarding gates and lounges. Most shops are on level 4, while the lounges and boarding gates are on level 3. The Emirates Lounge is located in Concourse G, opposite the Cathay Pacific Lounge. Qantas is a partner with Emirates. Unfortunately, there's no dedicated Emirates First Class Lounge outside Dubai. As such, this lounge can be used by both Qantas and Emirates Gold and Platinum members and business and first class passengers flying with either airline. Wow, the cleaning robot is so cool, it knows how to avoid my feet. The lounge has a long rectangular layout. As you enter, you'll find the business center on the left, equipped with workstations, a TV, and a self-service bar. On the right is the main dining area. Towards the end of the lounge, there are toilets. The overall color tone and decoration resonate with the lounges across the Emirates network, with towels neatly rolled and stacked in a pyramid shape. And of course, showers are available as well. In front of the main buffet table is an eye-catching buffet dome, which serves pre-plated desserts, appetizers, salads, dips, cheeses, and juices. They are all beautifully presented to the fine dining quality. I'm not a wine expert. Here are all the alcohol options available. This lounge lacks a proper bar with a bartender, so you'll have to pour your own wine and mix your own drink. As for the food, although there's no a la carte dining, I believe that Emirates provides the best lounge buffet worldwide. They offer a diverse selection of Middle Eastern, Western, and local dishes crafted with premium ingredients. The lounge chairs are all covered in leather, with most having universal power plugs and USB ports installed next to them. you will not see any planes outside the windows because the Cathay Pacific Lounge, located opposite ours, has taken all the apron views. For the purpose of this review, I decided to sample a bit of every hot dish. In general, I am thoroughly impressed with the variety and quality of the food here. Premium proteins such as salmon, duck and tuna are not always found in an airline's business lounge. Boarding for the flight typically starts around 45 minutes before departure. Emirates encourages its first class passengers to relax in the lounge until just 10 minutes before the gate closes. However, I prefer to unwind in my private first class suite, so I arrived at the gate early. The A380 aircraft flying me to Hong Kong today is in a special livery dedicated to Dubai's newest architectural icon, the Museum of the Future. The ring-shaped Arabic calligraphy encapsulated building encircles both sides of the aircraft, featuring the message "Journey to the Future" across the fuselage. There are 10 A380 aircraft painted in this livery. Following the retirement of most passenger Boeing 747s around the globe, the A380 has become one of the most easily recognizable aircraft to the general public. Wherever it goes, it always draws lots of attention. Emirates currently has 116 A380s in service with 7 different seating configurations. Most of these aircraft have 3 classes, while some have just economy and business, and the newer and refurbished ones offer 4 classes. The capacities range from 484 to 615 seats. This particular aircraft is a 3-class mid-range version. The entire lower deck is fitted with economy class seats in a 3-4-3 configuration. Hello. Moving upstairs, the first class section takes up the whole space before the upper deck door 1. The suites are in a 1-2-1 configuration with 4 rows along the windows and 3 rows in the middle, totaling 14 seats. The privacy divider between the middle seats can be lowered if you are traveling with a companion. There are no overhead storage bins, but we can store your suitcase or bags on the floor, I'll show you later. Although I've seen numerous pictures and videos of this product online, experiencing it firsthand feels totally different. I'm incredibly excited about this flight. As soon as I settled in, I was warmly greeted by the crew, and I asked for a glass of champagne as my pre-departure drink. I noticed that they poured me a glass of Mouet, which is typically served in business class. But don't worry, the superior Dom Pérignon will be available after takeoff.
Enjoy, sir.
Thank you.
Moments later, I was served some dates and Arabic coffee.
We have one with almond, with orange peel or plain ones. Enjoy.
Followed by an onboard menu with a wine list and a fresh towel. I am a huge fan of the A380 aircraft. I was lucky enough to visit the A380 assembly line in Toulouse in 2019. However, I don't like how thick the wall is between the inner window and the outer window on the upper deck. This significantly limits my view outside the window. Suvarnabhumi Airport currently has 2 active runways, and this afternoon we'll be taking off from runway 19 right. On the other hand, the thick windows have contributed to a quieter onboard environment, making it the quietest aircraft I've ever flown on. Now let's take a detailed look at my first class suite. Each suite has sliding doors that can be closed after takeoff, ensuring great privacy. The suite has a luxurious feel with its walnut veneer and gold trim. There's a mini wardrobe next to the doors. The front of the suite is fitted with a massive entertainment screen, a lamp, a light, and a built-in lighted makeup mirror that can be tilted open or closed. When open, you'll find an amenity pack from Byredo. Since this is a short flight, no other amenity kits or pajamas were provided. In the drawer, there's a notebook and pen that you can take home with you if you wish. As there are no overhead bins in first class, you can place your bags on the floor beneath the TV screen. The space is big enough to fit a carry-on suitcase. Underneath the table, there's a magazine holder where the headphones are stored. There's a universal power plug under the lamp, with two USB ports just below that. The coolest feature of this suite, aside from the sliding door, is this built-in minibar next to the armrest. With a simple push of a button, you have quick access to water and some soft drinks. However, as the minibar is not refrigerated, I still had to request ice from the crew. The other button here is for taking out the tray table. This is certainly the largest tray table I've ever seen on a plane. Very stable too. Pretty much everything in this suite can be controlled via physical buttons or touch screens. The window blinds have two layers, and the buttons allow you to manage all three windows together or separately. Above those buttons is a tablet that can be used to adjust the seat, the lights, and the sliding doors. It also serves as a mini entertainment screen where you can check the flight path or browse the movie options. Furthermore, there's another remote control inside the armrest. In terms of the storage space, there's a compartment here for small items. A blanket and mattress pad are stored here. The seat has a width of 23 inches, which is on the narrower side, but it was comfortable enough for me. I'm sitting on a large, firm pillow. And on the other side of the seat, there's a reading light and an air vent. Both armrests can be opened up, and each has a small tray, perfect for storing items such as glasses, rings, and a watch. In addition to a private suite, first class passengers have the privilege to use the shower in the sky. Emirates was the first commercial airline in the world to have showers on board. The two spacious bathrooms are located at the front of the upper deck. Each bathroom has underfloor heating. It's so spacious inside. There's a TV screen showing the flight information. Fresh towels are prepared, along with various toiletries and a huge selection of products from Voya. And there's a full-sized sink with hand towels, Voya hand wash, body lotion, and Bulgari fragrances. And here is a shower. Each passenger gets up to 5 minutes of water. The indicator on the wall shows you how much water you have left. The water pressure is quite good. The shower is certainly a bonus to the Emirates A380 First Class experience, especially during long-haul flights. Behind the first class section, the rest of the upper deck is fitted with business class seats. They are in a staggered 1-2-1 configuration, each with a pitch of 48 inches and a width of 18.5 inches. All of them are lie-flat seats, and as you can see, there are overhead bins above each seat. No trip on the Emirates A380 is complete without visiting the iconic in-flight bar. It's at the back of the upper deck and is reserved for business and first-class passengers. There's a dedicated crew member serving as a bartender, ready to make any drink you desire. Additionally, you can find some sandwiches and other snacks for nibbling. There's also a large TV displaying the progress of the flight. Seeing that I was filming, the crew offered to take a photo of me standing inside the bar. Emirates is definitely one of the most camera-friendly airlines in the world. The crew goes above and beyond to maximize my in-flight experience. Returning to my seat, it's time for lunch. The menu is put inside a leather binder. Emirates offers a dine-on-demand concept in first class, so you can eat whatever is on the menu whenever you want. As this is a short flight, the meal consists of only three courses, excluding canapés and the signature caviar service. This is reasonable, considering how little I paid compared to other Emirates first class flights. The drink list includes a wide selection of alcoholic beverages, teas, coffees, juices, and soft drinks. And there's a separate wine list with some of the most expensive beverages on a commercial airline. For instance, the 2013 Dom Pérignon, served exclusively on Emirates, retails for $400 per bottle in Australia. To start, since caviar is not available, I picked the other popular dish, Arabic meze. The presentation looks terrific, resembling a restaurant in the air. The meze refers to a selection of small and flavorful dishes commonly served before a main meal in the Middle East, shared among families and friends. The meze on Emirates includes three cold spreads, some cold dishes, and some hot items. Overall, it was a sensational and filling appetizer that showcased the best of the local cuisine. I totally enjoyed it. Shortly after finishing, the crew cleared my plates and immediately served my main course. The beef tenderloin dish looks simple. Steak, sauce, steamed asparagus, potato gratin, and some garnish. For safety reasons, there's no steak knife on board. As the steak was prepared in the central kitchen on the ground and the crew only had to reheat it, I couldn't select how I wanted to be cooked. However, they did it perfectly. They used an excellent cut of steak, it was cooked to medium, and cutting it with a regular knife was effortless. It was still tender and juicy, and the sauce was lovely. Since I had already enjoyed two very filling dishes, I opted for some fresh-cut fruits for dessert. In general, Emirates' first-class dining experience was sensational. I loved the large tray table, the private sliding doors, the convenience of watching a movie while eating, and the easy access to water in the minibar when thirsty. Time in first class flies by quickly. We are now only 60 minutes away from touching down. The TV screen is 29 inches in size. It's huge. Emirates' ICE entertainment system is one of the best in the world. Through the information panel, you can view the flight path. There are three exterior cameras on the A380 which provide outside views from different angles. The communication section mainly shows you how to connect to Wi-Fi. Sadly, due to a problem with the satellite, the Wi-Fi wasn't available for the whole flight. As for entertainment, Emirates offers up to 6,500 channels of movies, TV shows, music and games. The library is updated every month. Look at how many genres it has for its movie collection. Of course, leaning forward to touch the main screen is not always comfortable, especially when lying down. That's why Emirates provides another 9-inch tablet and a remote to control the screen. You can select the movie you want to watch on the tablet and the main screen will start the show right away. The Emirates First Class headphones are manufactured by Bowers & Wilkins. They are very comfortable to wear. And I must say, they are the best noise-cancelling headphones I've ever used. I decided to lie down for a bit, and the crew offered to make the bed for me.
Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Captain speaking. We're going to commence our gradual descent toward Hong Kong International Airport in about 7 minutes from now. Estimated time of travel will be after 35 minutes to 45 minutes.
This is pretty much a full-sized single bed. There's no narrow foot nook at the front, and you don't have to sleep sideways like on many business class seats. Even when lying down, the tablet is still within easy reach.
Thank you for
the bed is 78 inches or 198 centimeters long. There's plenty of space between my head and the wall. Unfortunately, there's no time for a nap, as it's time to return to planet Earth. The plane has started its descent into Hong Kong. Just before the seatbelt sign was turned on, the crew handed out some fine luxury chocolates. This flight has been truly eye-opening for me. It's my first time flying in first class, seeing a bar in the sky and a shower on the plane. Although it has been 15 years since this product was first revealed, and other airlines like Singapore and Etihad now have even bigger suites on the A380s, flying on the Emirates A380 First Class is still a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Of course, flying first class usually comes with a very high price tag. The two most affordable routes you can take are between Bangkok and Hong Kong and Sydney and Christchurch. I paid just over 900 Australian dollars for this flight, and I believe this is the cheapest Emirates A380 first class flight across its entire network, without using points.
Thank you for flying Emirates. We hope you enjoyed your flight. We look forward to seeing you again soon. Good evening.
Welcome to Hong Kong. If you are staying on Hong Kong Island, the quickest way to get there is by catching the airport express train. It runs from roughly 5:50 a.m. to 12:48 a.m. daily, and it takes just 24 minutes to reach Central Station. The ticket is more expensive than the buses, costing 115 Hong Kong dollars each way, but the journey is smoother and the train is less crowded. There's dedicated luggage space in each carriage. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video interesting, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more flight and train reviews. See you all in my next video.